everyone. I'm here with two lovely ladies, Fiona.
Hello.
And Rebecca.
Hello.
Of Fiona and Rebecca.
Rebecca and Fiona.
I'm sorry.
Doesn't matter.
It's all right, though. It's all right. So you guys are from Sweden, right?
Yes. Yeah.
I hear you guys have a mafia problem out there. You want to comment on that?
Angelo Ingrosso Axwell.
It's not true. They're never there, so no.
The mafia doesn't exist, apparently.
They left the building.
So, you ladies have a new album out, huh?
Huh? You like it?
I love you, man.
Do you like the album?
Do you love us, or do you like the album? Or do you love the title?
I love the fact that you finally made an album, you know, resembling your feelings about me.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, how do you feel about that?
I feel pretty good. It's a little overwhelming at first, you know, but yeah. I feel quite flattered, you know, that you would do that.
Yeah, but how did you respond? Like, how was your reactions and, like...
Have you listened
to a lot or did you feel, like, weird about it? Or?
Let's just say you had my full attention the whole time.
Okay, great.
You wrote this track, Sleep Alone, about you.
Yes.
And it's about being alone at this bachelor party, double polling, you know. And there are...
Double polling.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
You never went to a bachelor party?
When I'm sleeping and when I'm not with you, I'm sleeping alone. You know? And it's heavy and it's hard for me to handle all these feelings. And like, I don't even know how to get a sleep because it's hard. And we're trying to figure it out and we wrote a fucking whole album about it.
It's very hard.
Yeah.
How long have you ladies been in love with me for? Approximately.
Since November 2009.
All right. And you? Same?
Pretty much. No, it's a double. But I ended up like late December. Like, that was...
You were a late bloomer. But
yeah,
you
but
got on.
I was holding it back.
Your eye. And
I was
then
holding it back so bad, you know.
Holding back because she's in love with Adrian Lux. So she's always pushing her feelings down.
I've heard that. Heard that.
And it was hard for me to realize, you know. Like,
yeah.
I have to tell you, you're drunken, Rebecca, here. It's between your eyes. You're drunken. You don't know your feelings. It's in your heart. You can feel your heart, Rebecca.
Yeah.
I tell her.
Yeah.
Every day I tell her. You get closer to your feelings and then you can reveal your inner self.
That's very wise wisdom.
Yeah, she's so wise.
Can you both come closer to the mic?
Can I have my beer?
Can we both come closer to your pole?
Let me ask you something. Are you girls good at sharing?
The pole?
Yes. The pole is, that's a profession, you know. So we get paid to share.
Well, that's good.
So, I mean, like,
what do you mean, sharing?
Well, here's the thing. I've come to actually propose marriage to both of you. So
if you're like claiming or like talking about the Mormon thing.
Yes.
Oh my God! Do you have one for her?
Of course.
Yes. Of course. Oh my God! My fat fingers. I'm pushing it. Okay.
This is the first time. We actually talked about this. Oh, I get it.
We actually talked about this ever.
I think it's the left one.
Is this really happening to me?
Put it on, man.
I now pronounce us man and wives. You may lick your ring pops. What they don't know is I'm officially a registered minister, so this is actually technically legally binding.
Perfect. Finally, we're going to have a big party. Agir, we're married.
Agir, I'm flabbergasted.
All right. We're here with Rebecca and Fiona, wishing you
a happy marriage.